to crawl upon up.
That's right.
It's ridiculous. And nobody says nothing to them. Wonder why we have so many pregnancies in the United Pentecostal Church today, because mamas and daddies let things go on that should have corrected.
That's right.
And I'm not just talking about this church. I said the Pentecostal church. I'll never forget years ago over the Ed Hudson. I wasn't but maybe 12 years old. In the middle of service,
yeah,
he stopped and he told a young man and a young woman, he said, come here. They got up, they walked up to him. He said, you sit down right there.
Amen.
He said, where everything you do, I'll see just like God. You're not going to hide it. You know what? There wasn't a parent in the house who said a word. But you try doing that now and see what the mama and the daddy does to the preacher.
Come on.
They probably throw one of these chairs at him.
Come on.
Oh yeah, no, they definitely leave the church and never come back. They leave the church and never come back on a lot less than that.
That's true.
But I'm here to tell you, church, it's Bible. Are you gonna leave the Word of God so you won't feel like you're ashamed and run where they won't preach it and say, I'm all right now, I don't feel all that anymore? I just recently experienced someone, and I thought to myself, my God, don't do this. To them what you've done to Ananias and Sapphira. Lie to the man of God. Lie to the man of God. And then tell him, I knew it was God's will. They didn't know nothing. They ain't heard from God in so long, they wouldn't know if he slapped them side the head.
That's the truth.
Well, brother so-and-so said so-and-so. Well, brother so-and-so might not know the whole story either. All but just what you told me. Some say we can't make it to church tonight. It's Wednesday night. Who's going to miss us? And then Sunday morning, oh, well, we'll wait and go tonight. We're so sleepy because we stayed out all night doing something we probably didn't have no business to be doing anyway. And Brother Nelly, I just couldn't get up. Well, you didn't go to bed early enough.
You
got
to have that kind of sleep.
But you know what happens? Come Wednesday night, you miss it again. And we miss it again. It gets easier and easier. And then the pastor gets on the phone and he dials you up and says, my God, sister or brother, where have you been? We've been missing you. And you can tell they get mad at you for even calling them. Where's the shame in? They have no church. I'm going to tell you something right now. It gets easier and easier to miss church the more you miss it.
Right.
You can pray that you blew in the face. I don't care who you are. They said, you got more than I got, is all I can tell you. If you don't get to the point that you realize in your own life you need church, you need preaching, you need the church family.
That's right. We need each other.
Constantly in your life.
That's
That's right, amen.
I remember when I used to go to church seven nights a week and work all, nobody ever missed. Over there at Hudson used to have a house full on Saturday night livings. I'm talking about, hey, I seen them sitting in the windows. I seen them standing outside with their head through the window. They didn't have no screens, nothing like this. No air conditioning. Mosquitoes just slap him and go on praising God.
That's right.
My grandma used to tell me how they had to walk to church.
Yes.
Almost a mile from her house, down an old muddy road where the church was. Earl Eck was coming that part of the country and she received the Holy Ghost. And my mother received it when she was 17 years old. They got up every time they had church and walked down that old, mama said, old muddy road, old gum, but they had to take their shoes off and stop at the dipping bed. Anybody know what a dipping bed is? Huh? You run cattle through one side, they come out the other side, and they're dipped for fleas and ticks and all that. You're going up. They want to go to church so bad, if somebody didn't take them in the wagon, they pull their shoes off, waded through the mud, sat down to dip it back, washed their feet, put their shoes on, and went to church.
Yeah.
Because they wanted to go to church.
Yeah.
Do we just go to church because we think somebody thinks we're supposed to be there? Or do we go because we want to? I said something last time I preached, I think, that you got to have the want to. You got to have the desire in your heart to go to church. You got to have a desire to come in and tired and to take a shower and get dressed and get ready and go to church without any supper, by the way. Didn't have time. Had one weenie, one peanut butter and jelly sandwich out and a biscuit and sausage this morning. That's it. I'm a big man for no more than that. I went to Sister Andy's place over there. They fixed me a nice plate. That's because they saw. That preacher's a big man. Let's make sure we feed him. But church, I'm serious. If we don't get serious about living for God in this day and time, you know what's going to happen to us? There's going to be a bunch of us that's going to be sitting on a pew thinking you're all right. And the rapture's going to take place. And there's going to be some going to be taken and some going to be left. If you look at the scripture where it says there'll be two on the house, one will be taken and one will be left. There'll be two in the bed, one will be taken and one will be left. Two in the field, one will be taken and one will be left. That tells me 50%. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 8 of us would make it. If that's all it is. Now you can close your ears to what goes on in your seat. You can believe it don't matter. But I'm going to tell you something right now. God gave it to me. He said, you go preach where is their shame. Talk about it, church. We see kids going. We go pick up Olivia. And they got kids. They got little girls got skirts on up to their sitting down place. And then somebody wonders how they got raped or why they hooked up with some pervert on the internet and run off with them. Because nobody's got any shame anymore. Used to be, men didn't go around without a shirt on. No, sir, they didn't go around without. If they went around without a shirt on, somebody in the neighborhood condemned them to hell. And they knew it. That's the only way shame can come upon somebody is if they're scolded by the Word of God. Just like your little children, they will never, ever be any more than what you teach them to be. They'll either call good evil or evil good. Some people say, I don't want to go to church here because I don't want to hear that kind of preaching. I want to hear, pat me on the back, let's run the aisle, let's jump up and down, let's do this, let's do that. Hey, we do that when God moves.
Amen.
But what do you do when God moves in this way?
Come on.
Let me tell you something. You know why come? The Bible says leap for joy. You know why come we don't have too many leapers in this church? Must not be a whole lot of joy in their life. Praise the Lord. But there's a good side to all this. Simply, we can make a new start tonight.
Come on.
We can turn over a new leaf like we do on New Year's Day. Oh, come on, y'all. I ain't gonna drink no coaches this year. I ain't gonna watch watch no nakedness on television. I tell you what, you better be quick on the remote if you don't. Because you'd just be turning from one channel to another and see the awfulest things I've seen in my life. Stand to your feet. Think about what Luke 9:26 said. For whosoever shall be ashamed of me and my words, of him shall the Son of Man be ashamed. And when he shall come in his own glory and his Father's and of the holy angels. These altars are open tonight. If you have felt that God was in this sermon, if you felt the Spirit of God moving on you and you heard the words of God, you can come into Him tonight and ask forgiveness.